explorers. Have you ever wondered about the amazing things that happen on our planet? Like when the ground shakes, or a big storm comes, or a volcano goes boom? These incredible events are called natural disasters, and we're going to learn all about them. Natural disasters are like Mother Nature's surprises. Sometimes they're a little bit scary, but mostly they're just a way for our planet to show how strong and powerful it is. Just like you might stomp your feet or yell really loud, the Earth has its own special ways of releasing energy. These events are a natural part of our world, and even though they can be powerful, we can learn how to stay safe and appreciate the awesome forces of nature. Are you ready to dive in and become a natural disaster detective? Let's go! Nature is pretty amazing, isn't it? It gives us sunshine, rain, trees to climb, and oceans to splash in. But sometimes, nature likes to show off its muscles with incredible events we call natural disasters. Think of it like this. Sometimes you might have so much energy you just have to run around and shout. That's kind of what the Earth is doing during a natural disaster. Even though these events can be powerful, it's important to remember that nature is still our friend. So while we learn about natural disasters, let's also remember to appreciate all the wonderful things nature does for us every single day. Get ready to become a natural disaster expert. We're going on an adventure to discover all about earthquakes, volcanoes, tsunamis, hurricanes, tornadoes, and floods. We'll learn what causes them, how they work, and some super cool facts along the way. Learning about natural disasters is like becoming a detective. We'll look for clues, uncover secrets, and understand how these amazing events shape our planet. We'll also learn how to stay safe and be prepared if one happens near us. Have you ever jumped on a trampoline? It's bouncy and fun, right? Well, did you know that the Earth has its own giant, invisible trampoline underneath us? It's true. The Earth's top layer, called the crust, is made up of big puzzle pieces called tectonic plates. These plates are always moving and grooving just like you on a trampoline, but sometimes they get stuck and can't move past each other. That's when the fun begins. All that energy builds up like air in a balloon until, boom! The plates finally break free, creating a big shakeup we call an earthquake. These earthquakes can make the ground shake and rumble like a giant is stomping its feet. Buildings might sway, things might fall off shelves, and it can be a little scary. Imagine you have two pieces of sandpaper and you try to rub them together. It's tough, right? They kind of catch and stick. That's what happens with the Earth's tectonic plates. When they try to slide past each other, they get stuck and create friction. All that pushing and squeezing builds up a tremendous amount of energy. It's like stretching a rubber band really, really tight. Eventually, the pressure becomes too much, and the plates slip past each other with a sudden jolt. Scientists have a really cool way to measure how strong an earthquake is. They use a special tool called a seismograph. It's like a super sensitive pen attached to a very still weight. When the ground shakes, the pen wiggles and draws a line on a piece of paper. The bigger the earthquake, the bigger the wiggles on the paper. Scientists use these wiggly lines to figure out the magnitude of the earthquake, which is a fancy word for how much energy it released. They use a special scale called the Richter scale to measure this. Have you ever seen a bottle of soda pop shaken up? It fizzes and bubbles, right? Well, volcanoes are kind of like that. They're mountains with a secret deep inside. They have a chamber filled with hot, molten rock called magma. It's like a giant underground pot of boiling soup. Sometimes this magma gets really hot and starts to bubble. The pressure builds and builds until, whoosh! It erupts out of the top of the volcano. That eruption is a spectacular sight, with hot lava, ash, and gases shooting up into the air. Don't worry though, most volcanoes don't erupt all the time. Remember those tectonic plates we talked about in the earthquake section? Well, they play a big part in volcanoes too. Sometimes, these plates move apart, creating space for the magma to rise up from deep inside the Earth. It's like squeezing a tube of toothpaste. The magma has to go somewhere. Other times, the plates collide, and one plate gets pushed down beneath the other. This can also cause the magma to rise and create a volcano. So whether the plates are moving apart or colliding, it can lead to some pretty spectacular volcanic eruptions. When the pressure inside the volcano becomes too much, the magma bursts through weak spots in the Earth's crust, creating a vent or crater. Volcanoes might seem a little scary, but they're also super cool. Did you know that the word volcano comes from the Roman god of fire, Vulcan? It's true. And just like Vulcan, volcanoes are full of fire and fury. Here's another cool fact. The largest volcano on Earth is Mauna Kea in Hawaii. It's so tall that its peak is actually above the clouds. And if you think that's impressive, the largest volcano in our solar system is on Mars. It's called Olympus Mons, and it's 3 times taller than Mount Everest. When lava cools down, it hardens into rock, forming new islands and even continents over millions of years. So next time you see a volcano, remember that it's not just a mountain. It's a powerful force of nature that helps shape our world. Have you ever made a splash in the bathtub by jumping in really hard? That's kind of what a tsunami is like, but on a much, much bigger scale. Instead of a bathtub, imagine the entire ocean being splashed. Tsunamis are giant waves, way bigger than any wave you'd see at the beach. But here's the thing. Tsunamis aren't caused by wind or storms like regular waves. They're caused by something much more powerful. Earthquakes, underwater volcanoes, or even landslides that happen under the sea. This sudden movement creates a huge amount of energy that travels through the water, forming these massive waves. Tsunamis can travel across entire oceans at super speeds like a jet plane. And when they reach the coast, they can cause serious damage. Remember those tectonic plates we talked about in the earthquake section? Well, they play a big role in causing tsunamis too. When these plates move suddenly under the ocean, they can cause a massive displacement of water. Imagine dropping a giant rock into a pond. The water ripples outwards, creating waves, right? That's similar to what happens when an earthquake occurs under the ocean. The seafloor acts like that giant rock, creating powerful waves that spread out in all directions. These waves might not seem very big out in the open ocean, but as they get closer to the shore, something amazing happens. Tsunamis can be scary, but there are things we can do to stay safe. The most important thing is to be prepared and know what to do if a tsunami warning is issued. If you live near the coast, talk to your parents or teachers about tsunami evacuation routes. These routes will lead you to higher ground, away from the coast, where you'll be safe from the giant waves. Remember, if you feel a strong earthquake when you're near the coast, it could be a sign that a tsunami is coming. Have you ever seen a spinning top whirling and twirling around really fast? Well, a hurricane is kind of like a giant spinning top in the ocean. But instead of being made of plastic or wood, it's made up of powerful winds and swirling clouds. Hurricanes are enormous storms that form over warm ocean waters. They can be hundreds of miles wide, with winds that blow faster than a race car. That's fast enough to blow you off your feet. As these thunderstorms gather more warm, moist air, they start to spin faster and faster, just like a figure skater pulling their arms in to spin quicker. As the storm spins, it creates a low pressure area in the center, kind of like sucking air into a vacuum cleaner. Remember how we talked about warm ocean water being like fuel for hurricanes? Well, the warmer the water, the stronger the hurricane can become. It's like giving a race car super-powered fuel. As the warm, moist air from the ocean rises into the hurricane, it cools and condenses, forming thunderclouds and releasing even more energy. This cycle of warm air rising and cool air sinking creates powerful thunderstorms and those super fast winds that hurricanes are known for. Hurricanes have a special part in the center called the eye. The eye is actually calm and clear, kind of like a peaceful oasis in the middle of a raging storm. Scientists called meteorologists are like weather detectives. They use special tools like satellites, radar, and weather balloons to track hurricanes and predict their paths. This helps people prepare and stay safe by giving them time to board up windows, stock up on supplies, or even evacuate if necessary. Just like superheroes, there are brave people who work hard to keep us safe during hurricanes. First responders like firefighters, police officers, and paramedics are always ready to help those in need. Have you ever seen a really strong wind pick up a leaf, a plastic bag, or even a whole tree and spin it around really fast? Well, a tornado is kind of like that, but much, much stronger. It's like a giant swirling column of wind that reaches all the way from the clouds to the ground. Tornadoes are known for their distinctive funnel shape, They look like giant ice cream cones spinning out of the sky. But don't let their appearance fool you. These funnel clouds are some of Mother Nature's most powerful storms. They can pack winds stronger than a rocket ship taking off. These powerful winds can pick up houses, cars, and even really heavy objects like school buses. It's like the tornado is playing a giant game of pickup sticks. Tornadoes might seem like a mystery, but they actually form from powerful thunderstorms. When warm, humid air collides with cold, dry air, it creates a lot of instability in the atmosphere. It's like mixing oil and water. They just don't like to stay together. This clash of air masses can cause the air to start rotating, kind of like a spinning top. As the air spins faster and faster, it can create a funnel cloud that stretches down from the thunderstorm. If this funnel cloud touches the ground, voila, you've got yourself a tornado. Tornadoes can be scary, but there are things we can do to stay safe. Be prepared and know what to do if a tornado warning is issued. A tornado warning means it's time to take cover. The safest place is a basement or storm cellar. If no basement, go to an interior room without windows. Crouch down and cover your head to protect from debris. Hey there, water explorers! Have you ever wondered what happens when it rains really, really hard for a long time? Like when the rivers and streams overflow their banks and the water doesn't know where to go? That's called a flood. Floods happen when there's too much water in one place at one time. It's like trying to fit all your toys back into their box after a long day of playing. Sometimes there's just not enough room. So the water spills out, covering everything in its path. Now, floods might not sound as exciting as tornadoes or earthquakes, but they can be just as powerful and important to understand. Sometimes floods happen slowly, giving people time to prepare. Other times they can happen quickly, taking everyone by surprise. But don't worry, just like with all natural disasters, we can learn how to stay safe during a flood. So put on your imaginary rain boots and grab your trusty umbrellas. It's time to dive into the world of floods. Remember how we talked about hurricanes bringing lots and lots of rain? Well, sometimes all that rain can cause rivers, lakes, and oceans to overflow, leading to floods. It's like filling a bathtub too high. Eventually, the water spills over the edge. But heavy rain isn't the only thing that can cause floods. Sometimes dams can break, or ice jams can block rivers, causing the water to back up and flood surrounding areas. It's like putting your finger over the end of a hose. The water has nowhere to go but up and out. In some places, melting snow can also cause floods. As the weather warms up, all that snow turns back into water, flowing into rivers and streams. If the ground is still frozen, the water can't soak in and it has nowhere to go but, you guessed it, flood. Floods can happen anywhere in the world, from big cities to small towns. But no matter where they occur, it's important to understand why they happen so we can be prepared and stay safe. Section 3. Staying safe when the water rises. Floods can be dangerous, but there are things we can do to stay safe. Be prepared and know what to do if a flood warning is issued. A flood warning means it's time to take action. Talk to your parents or teachers about flood evacuation routes. These routes lead to higher ground, away from the water. It's like climbing to the top of a playground slide. You'll be safe. Stay calm and follow adults' instructions. Never try to walk or drive through floodwaters. You can't tell how deep the water is or what's hidden beneath. It's always better to be safe than sorry. By being prepared, we can stay safe when the water rises. Wow! We've learned so much about natural disasters today. From the ground-shaking earthquakes to the fiery volcanoes, the giant waves of tsunamis to the swirling winds of hurricanes and tornadoes, and the overflowing rivers of floods, we've explored some of the most powerful forces on our planet. They're all part of nature's balancing act. Just like we need sunshine and rain to help our gardens grow, the Earth needs these natural events to release energy and stay healthy. It's a reminder of how awesome and powerful our planet really is. We've talked a lot about staying safe during natural disasters, and that's because it's super important. Remember, knowledge is power, and the more you know about natural disasters, the better prepared you'll be to stay safe if one happens near you. Always listen to your parents, teachers, or other adults during an emergency. They're there to help keep you safe. If you hear a warning about a natural disaster, don't panic. Just remember the safety tips we've learned today, and you'll be just fine. Remember, it's always better to be safe than sorry. So make sure you know your family's emergency plan, practice it regularly, and always keep a watchful eye on the weather. By being prepared, we can face any natural disaster with confidence and courage. And remember, even though natural disasters can be powerful, so can teamwork and kindness. Helping each other out during tough times is one of the best ways to stay safe and strong. Well, explorers, we've reached the end of our natural disaster adventure. We've learned so much about these amazing events, from how they form to how to stay safe. But our journey of discovery doesn't have to end here. If you liked learning about natural disasters, give this video a big thumbs up and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more fun and educational adventures. The world is full of incredible things to discover, so keep asking questions, keep exploring, and never stop learning. Who knows what exciting adventures await us next time? Until then, stay curious, stay safe, and keep on exploring.